Hi friend, welcome back to my channel. Today I am so excited to share with you that I resubscribed to the Face Story sheet mask box. Oh my gosh. So if you've been here a while, you already know that sheet masks have been a real facet of my hoarding that I've never really talked about until I started to focus on it in my project Use It Ups. And it was there that I was able to really make a concerted effort. And I actually had what I thought was a really lovely skincare routine. I basically was doing 3 nights a week of doing more of a moisturizing type of skin balancing mask. And then 2 nights a week, I was doing a treatment mask, and it was just delightful. My skin was responding very, very well to it. And in the back of my head, I kept reminding myself that as a reward, if I got to a place in my collection, I could finally resubscribe to my Face Story box. And wouldn't you know it, for Black Friday, they were doing a ridiculous sale. They basically had their 12-month subscription, which is the, I believe, 7 Lux is what this is called. Let's see. Yeah, the 7 Lux. So you basically get 7 sheet masks a month, and then they occasionally will toss in other type of skincare items. That was on sale, and then I had a 40% off code on top of that. So I basically only am paying a fraction of a price per box. And I have found, especially this winter, that my skin is super dry. In fact, it's so dry that I don't even want to do treatment masks. I'm more into the hydrating, moisturizing, balancing types of masks, which is predominantly what I remembered and what I had in my sheet mask collection coming from Face Story, was what they tended to provide mostly in their boxes. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you month to month what I get in here. I love Face Story as a company. I feel like they are very educational based, and they're also big into Korean skincare, which is really great because Korean skincare tends to have lower price with high quality ingredients, which I think is really, really awesome. So I like them a lot. Let's go ahead and dive into what I got in my first month. So we'll start with the skincare bonus, which is this beauty water. I love that it's not a full size. Actually, I think that it's nice that it's on the smaller end just so I don't have tons of these types of products coming in each month. But they basically say that you can slough off dead skin cells while hydrating and preparing the skin. This multitasking product can act as a cleansing water or as a toner. The reason they love it is that it can be used as a toner, a cleansing water, or an exfoliator. They say it's moisturizing and refreshing and delivers an even glow. It's packed with plant extracts to help smooth, calm, and hydrate the skin. And they say that this retails normally for $8. So again, very reasonably priced. I am currently almost out of the toner I'm using, so I'll double check the ingredients to make sure that they are pregnancy safe. And if so, we'll start using this as my next toner, which is really exciting. Now we can talk about sheet masks, and I have a really fun one that I think is super exciting. It is a nail mask. I've never heard of this before, but I'm very intrigued. They say our nails deserve a little TLC too with all our typing and scrolling. This mask pack will help moisturize and nourish nails with ingredients like shea butter. It's the cherry on top of your self-care routine. It says it's perfect for dry nails, which who doesn't have dry nails this time of year? And I love that it's shaped almost a little bit like a nail polish bottle. So I think it's really fun. The back of the picture makes them look like you're putting on little hats onto your nails, which I think is just very fun. It's a different experience beyond just a hand mask. So I appreciate the uniqueness of something like this. And I hope to see more unique masks like this in future boxes. Another sheet mask we got is the Farm Skin Olive Firming Sheet Mask. They describe it as a cream type sheet mask to help firm and nourish the skin with the power of olives. The tensile sheet mask material adheres smoothly and is made from eucalyptus and cotton for a soft and environmentally friendly mask. I will say one thing I love about the Face Story mask, whether it's their brand or ones that they feature, all of the sheet masks are beautifully textured. They're not scratchy at all. They don't feel cheap. They all feel like they have like a fibrous, soft texture to them. And this sounds like it's very much the case as well. This one retails for $3. I'll also say a perk of this box and all boxes is that they sell these on their website. So if there's one that you really, really love, you can get your hands on it pretty easily, which I think is another nice feature of the boxes. Our third mask is the Daily Veggie Mask. This one is described as being nourish your skin with benefits of red wine. This mask will provide intense hydration and will leave your skin with a healthy glow. Very curious about that. This one retails for $3.50. I'm definitely gonna mispronounce the brand name for this one, but it's the Skin Mammon Squalane Essence Mask. They say it's a luxurious gold foil mask that calms the skin while providing deep moisture. This mask brings out your skin's inner radiance, so you'll look glowy from within. So looking forward to this one. This one retails for $3.50 as well. My game plan for these, PS, is to probably still put them in my Project Use It Up. That way I can talk about them and kind of keep them on my radar. I definitely don't think I'm gonna do sheet masks 5 days a week that are all these like nourishing dry skin type, but probably keep it at three. And that's also why I like the idea of this box, because getting seven sheet masks and using, you know, typically 2 to 3 a week, I could reasonably get through all of them in a single month since I don't have a massive backstock of sheet masks anymore. We did get a couple of sheet masks from Face Story's line that they have, their in-house line. So the first one that we got was the Moon Velvet Mask. I have never tried this mask before. It says it's one of our all-time faves, now reformulated to not include fragrance. This eco-friendly tensile sheet mask hugs the contours of your face with a creamy essence. Use this at night to wake up with velvety, soft skin. Definitely sounds lovely. Looking forward to trying this one out. Retails for $3. The other one that they included, I've tried before. It's the Woe, that H2O. I used this one up in my current Project Use It Up for this year. This has also been reformulated, it says. So it's one of our OG masks. This two-step mask is now reformulated to provide intense hydration without the added fragrance. You'll be wowed by the hydrating and plumping effect it gives. So you have basically like this ampoule up here that you apply and then you put the actual mask on afterwards. I thought at first being two steps, it was like very involved, but it really isn't. So I'll probably use this up pretty quickly now that I know how great it works. And then the last one that we have is the Dito Skin Rubios Tea Time Mask. They say nothing like having a hot cup of tea while relaxing. This mask will help revitalize and brighten your skin so you can stay glowy all day long. Again, retails for $3. These truly are like K-beauty types of masks. You can see the instructions in Korean. They do sometimes have them in English, but what I like again about the educational aspect of Face Story is on the actual card, they tell you clearly like how to work with all of these masks. It says cleanse and tone, apply the mask for 10 to 20 minutes, and then remove the mask and pat down the remaining essence. So even if you have a mask where you don't want to use Google Translate and you don't have any English instructions, they make it really friendly because it's true. All the masks typically have those same three steps. So I, again, love Face Story. I'm so excited about having the subscription back in my life. Like I literally haven't had it in years. I jumped on the bandwagon when they first like launched as a brand and was really into the masks. And since then, they've really evolved. They didn't have their own skincare line when they first started. They were just doing these types of K-beauty masks. And I just loved them as a company. I think they're really great. I follow them on Instagram and they have, again, a lot of educational content on there. And I think that their heart of their company and their philosophy is really aligned with education and quality ingredients and not just pumping out product for you to buy, which really resonates with me. So I'm a big fan of them. I will link this box down below in case you want to subscribe because they might still have some kind of sale running, but I got such a deal and I'm so pumped to have this each month to share with you. I'd love to know your thoughts down below in the comments. As always, thank you for being here. It really means a lot to me to have you spending some of your day with me, and I'll talk to you in the next video real soon. Bye.